YouTube, welcome to Cafe Innova and welcome to our reaction to Bill Conti. We are going to react to the song Gonna Fly Now. This is our first time single take on this reaction to Gonna Fly Now. Let's get started with our reaction. This is requested by our patron DJ John.
Hope you're having a great time, DJ John. Let's listen to Bill Conti for the first time with all of you. Movies, not sure which one. Yeah, while trains and things like that, this place. Yeah, I mean it's sounds familiar. Not sure exactly which part of the movie. Don't even remember.
It says Rocky Balboa. So which part was that?
Don't even remember the stories actually of the movies. I just remember one where he's fighting a Russian boxer. That is one I remember. The usual American and Russian enmity portrayed on the big screen. It was good to listen to. I don't know what they were singing, the choir or whatever that was part of it. What were they singing? Were they singing
the title Gonna Fly Now?
Fight Now, or, okay, Fly, Gonna
yeah,
Fly Now.
Yeah, I think that line I heard, I don't know what the rest was. Yeah.
Pretty good. I don't know what is the role of Bill Conti in this exactly. Because
I think
there was
the
a guitar solo in there, there was... Of course, the trumpets blaring almost throughout. I don't know what role does Bill Conti have in this. Should be specific. I mean, he's given all the credit of this. So what is his role? Is he the conductor, the Zubin Mehta of this piece, or what? Don't know.
I like that. I like the composition. I don't know whether it is Bill Conti or whoever has done it, but since it is under his name, the composition was good. It's a lot of music. It's a lot of music that is playing at any moment. And then that guitar comes, you don't even expect a guitar in a music like that. So that was quite something. It was unique. The whole composition is unique. And it does remind, I have not seen Rocky, any of them, I think. May have seen a scene or two here and there, just playing by somebody. But I've never seen any of the movies of the Rocky. And this definitely feels like it could go with all those Kung Fu movies, Karate Kid and all that, when they are training and, you know, special fights are going on in those times. So it does sound like a theme song for any of these kind of movies that are, you know, physical, challenging, what should we call, martial art movies.
Yeah, it's typical of Hollywood to kind of build up and increase this fake enmity that they have with all these countries, mm-hmm. and portray them on the big screen. And then actually that fake enmity, which starts off as possibly fake enmity, actually turns into real enmity. And you can see the suffering of the people who go there. You know, those who belong to these so-called countries where Americans hate. Countries. So when people from those countries immigrate there, or they are already living there for maybe 2-3 generations, they are bullied, they are abused at school, at work, in their neighborhood. There, all that is done to them, and nothing much is done by the government to stop it, really. You never hear of actual concrete measures being taken to stop this, what has started from a movie or TV show and become actually a problem in the country. Real problem. Nothing. The government does nothing. In fact, it tries to use it as a vote bank tactic. So it actually uses it, you know, as let's see if we can play both sides and get the most out of it. So nothing much is done. I feel really sorry for all the Russians and the people who look like Russians but possibly are Polish, who live in the US and do lot of hard work. And not just the Russians now, of course. Now America's enemies are all over the world. So you'll have Indians, you'll have Chinese, you'll have Japanese, you'll have Germans, you'll have French, you'll have everybody who's a so-called enemy of an ordinary American. And of course, let's not forget the Iranians or the Iranians, as Biden would say, or anyone from his party. But anyway, let's end it right here. It's sickening, kind of sickening when I... you know, have to talk about such things because it's such a... I mean, for me, it's so weird. It's so weird when these kind of fake enmities are created by these movie producers out there and by the governments, and then it rolls on to the people.
It's... Savio, you got the order wrong. It's not the Hollywood that starts it. It's the CIA and the government that decides what movies should be produced because they know the movies that, you know, are watched by people has... long-lasting impact and impression on people's minds. So there has been many, many studies. There have been so many documents that have leaked of CIA. They do it on purpose, I think, that have indicated that they set out a theme for their movies. And then under that theme, whatever has to be set, narrative has to be set, that is set for the next decade or two. So if a country has to be, you know, demonized, the movies will be made as per that agenda. If the movie, the countries have to be undermined or, you know, played in a lower class so that the people think that they are better than them and things like that, then movies will be made with that tone. So the tone is decided by the government. It's not the Hollywood at times that does that. They just follow the orders.
Yeah, whatever it is, I think the Americans are equally to blame, the ordinary Americans, the average American, equally to blame because they love... They love enmity, they love war, they love hatred for some reason.
That's a mental condition.
And that's sad. That's really sad. There are certain countries that love meditation, love good things, love nature. But then you have a country who loves violence, who loves guns, who loves weapons, who loves hatred, who loves all those evil things. It's sickening. It's kind of sickening. Let's fly now to the next reaction. Oh, it's so sad. Good music in there, but when it's created for such evil things or to market such evil things, I don't like it.